Welcome back to Living Aid Away, everybody. Now, she has two exciting shows this weekend. One at Palikū Theater, one at Blue Note Hawaii, and our friend Raiatea Helm is here to invite all of you to her shows. Raiatea, welcome.
Aloha kakahiaka.
I was gonna say, Mikey. Sis, it's been a minute since we've had you on the Living Aid Away set.
Yes.
This was all brown. How are you doing?
Nice. I'm doing great.
Yeah?
Thank you. Yes.
I love it. You know, we're talking about your two shows that's happening this weekend. Hoku and another one happening. What can people expect from your shows this weekend?
So I'm teaming up with Spring Wind Quintet and in celebration of 40 years of chamber music Hawaii. We are sharing mele Hawaii through just beautiful sounds of spring, the wind instruments.
Pretty.
Yeah.
I love
so
that.
I'm really excited. I've grown a great appreciation for, you know, orchestral music since my first performance in 2005 with the Honolulu Symphony.
Okay.
You know, and it's, I fell in love ever since, and I've had, you know, several opportunities to collaborate with ensembles through orchestral music.
So I love that. You know what, let's piggyback on the topic of collaboration.
Yes.
I wanna know, how does, you know, this collaboration affect the pieces you selected for your performance?
So first of all, you know, I've always loved collaborating. That's been one of my favorite parts of, you know, performing and sort of getting a feel of different artists that share the same passion and love for just music. But in this case with Spring Wind Quintet, you know, it really highlights mele Hawaii. You know, it gives a different color to music, and you know, not just only the ukulele guitar, steel guitar that we're very familiar with. You know, it's always nice to see what else can accompany, you know, mele.
Yeah.
The text and the poetry, and
I love that.
And keeping it, you know, true and authentic.
Right. Well, can we piggyback on that for a little bit?
Sure.
I wonder a little bit about, is that hard for you to do, to, you know, think of all of those elements coming together as one?
Well, I mean, it is a process, you know, but it's really fun.
Yeah.
Because you, as a performer, you know, as long as you're open-minded and you just kind of know how to navigate, and it also kind of helps too when you can, you know, read music and understand a little bit of that Western theory. But, you know, my job is to really feel the mele. And being able to work with, you know, musicians from different styles of music, it's a learning experience.
Beautifully said.
Yeah.
I love that. You know, something that we also know about you is that, you know, you are a board member for the Chamber of Music here in Hawaii. How long have you been a board member?
I've been a board member for a little over a year.
Okay.
And it's a new role, but I'm so grateful because this is, you know, working with folks who've been in the industry for 40 years, you know, and more, to get to learn. And the beautiful thing about it is to bridge Hawaiian music with classical music and chamber music. So
I love that.
And being that, you know, person to sort of share that with the next generation is key.
Well, you know, let's also piggyback on the topic of next generation. You know, we're seeing a lot of musicians giving back to the next generation and really encouraging them to pay their music forward when it comes to, you know, especially Hawaii music, right? What are some pieces of advice that you would have to give the next generation that you've learned throughout your industry, your time in the industry?
I mean, how long do we have?
Yeah, tell me. Well, we have 3 minutes.
You know, I'm so blessed.
Yeah, you are.
I grew up on Molokai. You know, we didn't have, you know, many music programs. But in the 7th and 8th grade, I sort of explored band.
Okay.
We had a teacher, Miss Jordan, bless her heart. She came all the way from Michigan to teach my friends and I band.
Yeah.
And music theory. So I picked up the trumpet because I thought that was a cool instrument. But, you know, we tried. It was hard. But from that point on, you know, I discovered Hawaiian music. Mm-hmm. I kind of forgot about, you know, band and all the different instruments. And then later on, I realized that, you know, when we go back to the 1800s, mm-hmm. you know, our Hawaiian ancestors were performing these instruments, brass instruments, string instruments, wind instruments, and they were composing and they could read, they could write. I mean, they were just amazing. Mm-hmm. And this is the history, you know, like the Royal Hawaiian Band.
Yeah, for sure.
And folks who came after them, you know, this is the history that we kind of missed. So it's my, you know, kuleana to learn as much as I can and share it with the next generation, you know, to foster the importance of musical literacy and to, you know what, hey, learn an instrument. Mm-hmm. You know, pick up an ukulele, but also pick up a guitar, piano, learn different instruments.
Yeah. Especially here in Hawaii, you know? Yeah, with all of the instruments, you know, at our, you know, like literally at the fingertips of our hands, you have so many resources to take advantage of. And is that kind of what was the motivation and the foundation for this upcoming concerts?
Well, I think it's a collection of, you know, a lot of things that have been placed in my life. And, you know, I'm so fortunate. So before COVID, I received an opportunity to serve Lili'uo Kalani Trust.
Awesome.
And many of us have known it as QLCC, right? And, you know, being that my father was a beneficiary of Lili'uo Kalani, you know, when she signed the deed of trust in 1909, she made sure that, you know, her assets would support Hawaiian, you know, orphans and destitute children. Right. And, you know, just kind of connecting to that from being a performer, it really humbles you, you know, and it's been a really great journey to see the work that goes behind, you know, grooming children and providing social services and youth development to help them thrive. So it's
Okay, so, you know, I could talk to you for days and days and days on end, but, you know, this weekend, if anybody wanted to come check you out, what's a good website that they can get tickets?
Oh, yes. So chambermusichawaii.org is where you can get tickets for the Paliku performance, which happens tomorrow.
Awesome.
Tomorrow at 7.
Perfect.
And then Blue Note on Sunday at 6:30.
Well, you guys are looking at it on your screen right there, bluenotehawaii.com. You guys stay with us. We have so many more things to cover on Living 808. Raiatea Helm!
Oh, hello!
Thank you so much for coming on to Living 808. You guys, we love having you on, so you're more than welcome to come whenever you want.